And the man who is originally behind the HSBC data that is causing tremors around the world today, Ave Falciani, spoke exclusively to NDTV's Nupur Tiwari, hours before journalists from 47 countries released names of account holders. Now, the black money whistleblower has confirmed that the Indian government has sent him a formal proposal to help with the black money investigations, and he has agreed to come on board. Now, he said he, however, himself would never reveal names publicly.
India has come to you with this agreement, so to speak, but they are asking you, I believe, client-specific information. Now, you had right from the beginning said that you wanted to avoid this. You had insisted on some sort of a drastic approach, a kind of overhaul of sorts of the investigation against black money. Are you disappointed that you're being asked for only specific information?
Not at all. I think it's important to progress step by step. Of course, we need to know each other better, to understand clearly what kind of information they need, because initially, only what French authority thought were useful were given to India. And I proposed and we accepted to move in another way where all the available information will be explained, exposed, presented, and so afterward they will be able to select what could be useful for them.
So I believe you have been offered an award by the Indian government in return for your services?
It was decided that offered that if they can retrieve incomes, tax from that, a part, few percentage of that will be rewarded to me. Mm-hmm. And of course, I will just in this case, if it happens, reveal it all publicly. And of course, we will use it to fight corruption.
How much do you already know?
You have in one side billions of informations, billions, and representing, if you're summing up all the assets, hundreds of billions, leading to hundreds of billions of assets. Of course, for India, as you know, because it plays a big role in international tradings and all this, you will find the traces, the tracks of all the commercial activities, business that is done and passing through such countries. Afterward, if you go and if you want to have names, of course, I will never expose them. Why? Because it's much more efficient to hide such information. Once you have them...
You mean you'll share them with investigators,
exactly,
but not with the public?
It's a strategy. Hmm. It's a good and efficient strategy not to disclose most of the time the persons. If you have two, it is in the case they are publicly well-known, publicly exposed. In this case, it could have an educational effect. Mm-hmm. It is okay. There are no risks.
They you mean if they're public figures, you think
of
that...
Of course. But it's not my choice. No. I observe that this was done in Italy. This is done in many countries. They decided them by themselves to do so.
To expose publicly the names of public figures.
Of course. And this makes sense. Because... Of course, it can dissuade it, I mean, prevent people to be tempted by that, thinking they will be in total impunity. But afterward, if you, let's say, separate different cases, and if you agree that time to time you need people to be able to reach an agreement that will be the best for citizens, to defend the citizens' interests, in that case, it may be efficient not to disclose the name, because not disclosing the name of the person under investigation will give you the opportunity to investigate also the neighborhood of this person.
The network.
The network around. And doing so, it will extend for the investigators the chance to get new cases.
It seems there will be an in absentia hearing that will happen, and you are likely to be given a prison sentence in Switzerland?
Yeah, most probably it will be exactly as you said, a jail sentence. And I already been to jail thanks to the international warrant. But this is also part of the, let's say, of the fight. You know, it's something that will keep, sooner or later, pressure on them.